When you're working with analyzers, please always wear your gloves, the safety goggles, and the coat. This video shows how to perform the maintenance of Liquiline system CA80. I will show you the maintenance on the example of CA80 ammonium today. The maintenance of CA80 is really easy, and it can be performed without any tools. For the maintenance of CA80, you need the maintenance kit CAV800. It basically consists of dispensers and filter mats, hoses, and smaller parts like the O-ring of the sample collector. Okay, so let's do the maintenance. In the first step, we stop the analyzer and go to the manual mode. Therefore, we press mode and select the manual mode. Now we are waiting for the analyzer to stop. When the current action is none and the analyzer is in the manual mode, we have to stop the sample preparation. Therefore, we go to menu, operation, manual operation, sample preparation 1, and stop the sampling. Now we can prepare the analyzer for the maintenance. That means we empty the sample collector in the first step. Therefore, we go to menu operation, maintenance, decommissioning, and then empty the sample collector. This action takes about 5 minutes. Now the sample collector is empty and we need to remove the reagents and the bottle tray to get access to the dispensers, which we want to replace. So my suggestion is to simply remove the hoses from the liquid manager, hold them up a little bit so that the residual liquid can flow inside the bottle, and do that for all the different bottles. Then take the bottle tray out and reconnect the cap with the hose again to the liquid manager afterwards to have a possibility to do the cleaning of the whole system. So we will do that now and you see what I mean. So we remove R1, R2, standard, and the cleaner, and take out the whole bottle tray. So after removing the hoses and caps from the bottles and wiping the ends with a paper, we reconnect the hose and the cap to the liquid manager. The description which hose is connected where in the liquid manager is written here on the protection cover and also in the door. So, and the hose P from the sample collector also needs to be well cleaned with distilled water. And as this hose is a little short, we disconnect it here and have a longer piece of noprene hose. The noprene hose is also part of the maintenance kit. Then we connect it there. Now we take an empty beaker and put all the hoses inside the empty beaker. The reason for the empty beaker is that in the decommissioning procedure of the CA80, the whole system is flushed with air when you use an empty beaker. And at the last step of every decommissioning of the hoses and cleaning of the whole system, a backflush with air is happening, so that means some liquid will be pressed out of the hoses, and that's why we use an empty beaker. To clean the system, we do a decommissioning step. Therefore, we go to menu, operation, maintenance, decommissioning, and rinse the analyzer. So, when the system was flushed with air, in the next step, we flush it with distilled water. So, we use an empty beaker with distilled water and insert all the hoses into the distilled water. To rinse the system with distilled water, we press Rinse Analyzer again. In the last step, the whole system is flushed again with air, so we take out the hoses from the water and use an empty beaker again. We take the hoses out, dry them a little bit with the paper, and then we do the softer procedure again. After this last step, the whole system is clean and dry, so we can now replace the dispensers. We first remove the empty beaker, remove the protection cap, and now have a view to the dispensers. So all of these dispensers have a lifetime of 6 months. So every 6 months you need to replace them. And They are part of the maintenance kit, as I mentioned before. To replace the dispensers, go to Menu, Operation, Maintenance, Dispenser Replacement, and select the dispensers which shall be replaced. In our example, we replace all dispensers and press OK. Now we select Draw Up Dispenser. The linear drives of the dispensers are moving to the bottom now. Now that all dispensers are moved down, we can easily replace them. Therefore, we just open this click connector, turn the dispenser, pull it down, and remove it from the linear drive. The dispenser holders are also delivered with the maintenance kit. So we click the dispenser holder onto the dispenser and push the dispenser into the linear drive. Especially for dispenser number 7, it is very important that this host D6 is behind the dispenser. That's to guarantee a free outlet for the photometer. So we push the dispenser into the liquid manager and turn it. It is very important that between the liquid manager and the dispenser is a little space, because otherwise the dispenser may be leaking. We do the same thing for all the dispensers, and then we are done with the dispenser replacement. And now all the dispensers are replaced and we can remove and throw away the old ones. After the replacement of the dispensers, we have to reset the operating hours counter. Now we insert the protection cover again. And the bottle tray. And connect all the hoses to the liquid manager. As mentioned before, all the description where which hose needs to be connected is on a protection cover and also inside the door of the analyzer. If the white C-flex hose of reagent RK is worn out or damaged, cut it a little bit and then connect it again to the liquid manager. To insert the bottle software-wise into the analyzer, we go to Menu Operation, Maintenance, Bottle Replacement, Bottle Insertion, and here we select all bottles as they were automatically removed during the decommissioning step, and press OK. Now we confirm that the bottles were inserted. All bottles must be inserted software-wise into the CA80, otherwise no calibration or measurement is possible. So the bottle status must be inserted for all bottles. Every year it is necessary to replace the O-ring of the sample collector. This O-ring is also part of the maintenance kit. And now I'm going to show you how to replace the O-ring. We remove the hoses from the sample collector and also the level detection terminals. Then we remove the sample collector from its holder. Now we unlock the cap and put the beaker back into the holder. Then we remove the O-ring and replace it by a new O-ring from the maintenance kit. The new O-ring needs to be lubricated with the silicone grease included in the maintenance kit before it can be installed into the sample collector cap. Take out the sample collector again, put the cap on top and close the bayonet lock. Now reconnect all hoses and the level detection connectors. After the replacement, a new calibration of the system is necessary. To perform a manual calibration, go to Menu, Operation, Manual Operation, and Determine Calibration Factor. Please ensure that the nominal concentration is the same as written on the bottle of the standard solution. If this is the case, press OK. Now the calibration is beginning. After a successful calibration, we go back to the automatic mode. Therefore, press Mode and Continue Automatic Mode. Now the analyzer is starting its precise automatic measurement again. Also every year, the filter mats of the ventilation system of the analyzer must be replaced. And now I'm going to show you how this is done. The filter mats of the CA80 are located on the bottom of the analyzer. One is on the left and the other one is on the right side. To replace the filter mats, we open the click mechanism. This is easily possible without any tools. Then we remove the old filter mat and replace it by a new one from the maintenance kit. Now we close the holder again and are finished with the filter mat replacement. So this was a really easy and tool-free maintenance of the CA80. I hope you had fun!